Good morning everyone and Sairam. So how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Okay, so let's start today's lecture. So today we are going to start new chapter. Today we are going to start social and political life, second chapter, constitutional design. And this is part one. Okay, so first of all class children, in this chapter there are two topics. First one is the democratic constitution in South Africa and second one is the Indian constitution. But this year in this chapter in constitutional design we will only discuss about the Indian constitution, because this topic democratic in South Africa is not a part of your curriculum this year. Right, this topic is not a part of your syllabus this year. That's why in this chapter we will only discuss about the Indian constitution. Is it clear? Okay, now let's see the content or the topic which we will cover in this video. So first we understand what is constitution, then why do we need a constitution, or we can say the importance of constitution. Do we need a constitution? The next we will discuss making of Indian constitution, circumstances under which the Indian constitution was drawn up. The next, the path to constitution, and at last we understand about the constituent assembly. Okay, so let's start with the first topic. Okay, students, as you all know that there are certain rules and regulations. Now these rules and regulations followed by the people and the government in a democratic setup. All these rules collectively form constitution. Right? All these rules and regulations collectively form constitution. So basically constitution determines the rights of the citizens. It also determines the power of the government and its functioning. It is the supreme law of the country. So basically this chapter, constitutional design, help us how the constitution is designed by studying about its drafting in India. So what is constitution? It is a basic principles and laws of the nation, state and social group that determine the rights and the duties of the government, and also guaranteed certain rights to people in it. In simple word we can say that what is constitution? The basic rules that the citizens and the government have to follow are called as constitution. Clear? Now move on to the next topic. Why do we need a constitution? Now just tell me children, why do we need a constitution? So as I said, like the constitution of a country is a set of rules, right, that determine, or we can say that that determine the relationship among the people living in the territory, that means the citizens. It also determined the relationship between the people and the government, right? So yes, constitution is needed because first it protects individuals' right and fundamental principles govern the United States. Second thing is constitution places the government's power in the hand of the citizens. So it limits the power of the government and establish a system of checks and balance. So the primary function of the constitution is to lay out the basic structure of the government according to which the people are to be governed. Clear? Now next topic is, what do the constitution do? First of all, it generates a degree of trust and coordination, which is very necessary. Second, it specifies third is they tell us the rights and the duties of the government and the citizens, and the last one is the good society. So first of all, trust and coordination. Constitution generate a degree of trust and coordination. As I said, that is very necessary. Okay, if we talk about like India, so in India there's a different kind of people, they live together, right? So it is very necessary to generate trust and coordination among them. Second is specification. It specify how government will be constituted. Second thing is like how, or we can say that who will have the power to take the major decision in the country. Third point, rights and duties. Basically, constitutions lay down limits on the power of the government, and it also tells us what the rights of the citizens are. And last one is good society. Basically, constitution express the aspiration of the people to create a good society. Clear? Okay. Now let's understand the relationship between the democracy and constitution. Now here is the two sentence. First one is like, all countries that have constitution are not necessarily democratic country, but if all countries or all countries that are democratic will have necessary their own constitution. So the following example make this clear. First one is American Independence War, and the second one is French Revolution. So after the independence war against the Great Britain, America gave themselves written constitution. Second, after the French Revolution, French people, they just approved a democratic constitution. So since then, it has become practice in all the democracies, those who have written constitution. So we can say that all the countries that are democratic will have their own constitution, but all countries that have constitutions are not necessarily democratic. Now next topic is making of the Indian constitution. So basically, student, Indian constitution was drawn up under the very difficult circumstances. Basically, the making of constitution for the huge and diverse country like India, it's not a easy task. So now let's understand the making of the Indian constitution and also understand the problem faced while making Indian constitution. So as I said, the making of constitution for huge and diverse country like India, it's not an easy task. So the maker of constitution, they faced many problems while they are making Indian constitution. First of all, at that time, the people of the citizens, actually when they are making Indian constitution, at that time the people of the country, they were emerging from the status of subject to that of citizens. So at that time, basically country was born through the partition on the basis of religious difference. So this was a traumatic experience for the people of India and the Pakistan. Basically, as you know, that at that time, during the time of partition, at least 10 people were killed in both the side, in the border of both the countries. Basically, the partition related to the violence, right? This is the first problem they faced. Now the second big problem they faced, the merging of princely states with India or Pakistan. Okay, basically, students, before partition, that means before 1947, in India there were two types of states. First one is princely states, right? And second one is the provincial states. बिफोर इंडिपेंडेंस इन इंडिया देयर वर टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्टेट्स. फर्स्ट वन इज़ द प्रिंसली स्टेट्स एंड सेकेंड वन इज़ द प्रोविंशियल स्टेट्स. Now these princely states were ruled by the prince or rather king. Now these princely states was not direct under the control of British, but these provincial state was directly under the control of British. So when the British had left our country, so British had left it to the rulers of the princely states, whether these princely states they were merging with the India or they were merging with the Pakistan or remain independent, right? So it was they just left to the rulers of the princely states. Basically children, at that time there was 565 princely states were there. So the merging of these 565 princely states was not an easy task for the maker of Indian constitution. So basically when the constitution of country being written, so the future of the country did not look as secure as it does today. Basically the makers of the constitution, they had anxiety about the present and the future of the country. Is it clear? Move on to the next topic, the path to constitution. So the problem faced by the Indian makers, like the partition of India and Pakistan and after that the merging of these princely states. So despite all this problem, there was one big advantage for the maker of Indian constitution was that they did not create consensus about what a democratic country should look like, because much of consensus evolved during the time of freedom struggle. Okay, so the path to constitution. So as far back as in 1928, Motilal Nehru and eight other Congress leaders, they already drafted constitution for India. Right, just note down this point. In 1928, Motilal Nehru and the eight Congress leaders, they drafted constitution for India. Then in 1931, the resolution at Karachi of the Indian National Congress dwelt how independent Indian constitution should look like. Now both these constitution were committed to inclusion of, first of all, universal adult franchise. They both were agreed upon, universal adult franchise, right to freedom and equality, and to protecting the rights of minority in the constitution of independent India. Thus many basic values were also accepted by all the leaders much before the Constituent Assembly met to deliberate on the constitution. Okay, now basically many educated Indians were familiarized with the political and legislative institution during the colonial British rule. Basically during the time of British, they just give right to votes only a few. On the based, British introduced a very weak legislative system, and these were not fully democratic government, but Indians gained experience on the working of the legislative institution that helped them a lot to setting up their own institution and working on them. So that's why Indian constitution adopted many institutional details and procedure from the colonial, that means the British rule. Like for example, Government of India Act 1935. This basically idea we adopted from the colonial rule. So years of thinking and deliberation on the framework constitution had another benefit. Basically our leader gained, we can say that, confidence to learn from the other countries, but on their own term and condition. Basically, our leaders, our Indian leaders, they were very inspired by the events that took place across the world. Many of the Indian leaders, they were very inspired. Like, first of all, we can say that Indian constitutions adopted many institutional ideas and the procedure from the other countries. Like, first of all, India adopted the idea or the principle of liberty, freedom, and justice from the French Constitution. Next one is the Socialist Revolution in Russia had inspired many Indian leaders to think of shaping a system based on social and economic equality. Indian constitutions also adopted the practice of parliamentary democracy from the Great Britain, the Bill of Rights from the United States of America, but they didn't simply imitate these principles. Okay, now the next topic is the Constituent Assembly. Many educated Indians were familiarized with the political and legislative institution during the colonial British rule. Basically, during the time of British, they just gave voting rights only to few. So on that basis, British introduced a very weak legislative system, and this were not fully democratic government, but Indian gained experience on the working of the legislative institution that helped them a lot to setting up their own institution and working on them. So that's why Indian constitutions adopted many institutional ideas or details and the procedures from the colonial British rule, like the Government of India Act, the Government of India Act 1935. Basically, this idea we adopted from the colonial or the British rule. So year of thinking and deliberation on the framework constitution had another benefit, because our leader gained confidence to learn from the other countries, but on their own terms and conditions. Okay, basically at that time, Indian leaders, they were very inspired about the events that took place across the world. Indian leaders, they were very inspired, and Indian constitutions adopted many institutional detail and procedures from other countries also. Like, for example, first India adopted the principle of liberty, freedom, and justice from the French Constitution. Second is the Socialist Revolution in Russia also inspired many Indians to think of shaping a system based on social and economic equality. India also adopted the practice of parliamentary system from the Great Britain, and we also adopted the Bill of Rights from the United States of America, right? So all these ideas we adopted from the other countries, and all these factors contribute to the making of Indian constitution. Okay, now move on to the next topic, the Constituent Assembly 1946. Who then were the maker of Indian constitution? Right, now we understand who then were the maker of Indian constitution. But before that, first understand, what is Constituent Assembly? Okay, so the drafting of Indian constitution was done by an assembly of elected representative called Constituent Assembly, or in simple word we can say that an assembly of people's representative, that write the constitution for our country. Okay, now let's understand the Constituent Assembly 1946. So drafting of the constitution was done by an assembly of elected representatives, 299 members, called the Constituent Assembly, and they just keeping the following points in mind. First, universal adult franchise is the most important. Right to freedom, equality, and protecting the rights of minorities. Now, next thing is, the assembly was dominated by the Indian National Congress. It has many non-Congress members. The constitution doesn't reflect the views of its member alone. It expresses the aspiration of all the people. Now, the elections to the constitution. So first of all, elections to the constitution assembly were held in July 1946 and its first meeting was held in December 1946. Okay, so elections to the Constituent Assembly first were held in July 1946 and their first meeting held in December 1946. And soon after, the country was divided into the India and Pakistan. So the Constitution Assembly was also divided into the Constituent Assembly of India and Constituent Assembly of Pakistan. Right, so the Constituent Assembly that wrote the Indian Constitution had how many members? 299 members. Right, the assembly adopted the constitution on 26th November 1949. Just note down this point, the Constituent Assembly adopted the constitution on 26th November 1949, but the constitution came into effect on 26th January 1915. So to mark this day, we celebrate January 26 as Republic Day every year. Right? Republic Day. Now second thing is, the accepting of this constitution is that the constitution representative the people of India, and at that time there was no universal adult franchisee at that, so the Constituent Assembly could not have been chosen directly by all the people of India. It was elected mainly by the member of the existing provincial legislature. Right, now the assembly was dominated, as I said, like the assembly was dominated by the Indian National Congress, the party that led India's freedom struggle. But the Congress itself included a variety of political groups and opinions. The assembly had many members who did not agree with the Congress in social terms too. The assembly represented members from different language groups, caste, classes, religions, and occupations. Even if the Constituent Assembly was elected by universal adult franchise, its composition would not have been very different. So finally, the manner in which the Constituent Assembly worked gives to the Constitution. The Constituent Assembly worked in the systematic upon manner. First, some basic principles were decided and agreed upon. Then, this constitution, the drafting of this constitution was prepared by Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar. Then a drafting committee chaired by Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar prepared a draft constitution for discussion. So several rounds of through discussions took place on the draft constitution clause by clause, and more than 2000 amendments were considered. How many? 2000 amendments basically were considered. The members deliberated for 114 days, spread over 3 years. Every document presented and every word spoken in the Constituent Assembly has been recorded and preserved, and these are called Constituent Assembly debates. Debates. So that's all for today. I hope you all understood all these topics. Now the next topic, guiding values of the Indian Constitution, we will discuss in next video. Thank you and have a nice day, children.